Amen. So this morning, I am calling again unto revival. What area are you seeing? When the word of God came in, did you get yourself revived? And when it came, what were the measures or what were the signs of knowing that someone is revived? What is the measure to see in your life whether you are revived? If you have revived, begin to thank God and bless God. But if you are lacking something in, look for that deficiency and make it be, because there must be the word of God. And then the entrance of God's word bring light and bring understanding. When it enters, the first thing that will come is that somebody will see that I'm not living right. And therefore you begin to talk to God about it. And now you make your decision that you repent of it and ask God for forgiveness. And then you know that you are moving into action. You're not going to have anything to do with that very thing. And that is when revival breaks forth. It begins with the word of God. It gets in the first step of confession. The second step is repentance. The third step is action. Action. And that's how it should be. Beloved, I leave you with this. And I tell you that, which area are you going to ask for revival on you? It begins from you. It will enter into your family. And then it will be extended to the church, and the church as a large, to the community, and from the community it will go as a nationwide thing. It begins with the first person. You are the one that you need revival. And if it is that way, if that has happened to you, you now ask for your household. You want your household to be under that revival. Then you ask for your church to be under revival. Then you ask for your community to be under revival. Then you ask for the nation that it will come, because this is going to be the gathering that God will do. When Christians can repent, there will be revival. Let's do it together, beloved. So let's go before the Lord and talk to God. I don't know which area you are going to. If you're going to station yourself on your church, pray. If it is about your family, pray. If it's about yourself, you pray, because revival goes from one stage to the other. Which stage are you going to pray? Different people with different kind of capacity and capabilities. And so I don't know the range that you're going to do, because we are asking for revival. And when the revival comes, it takes only God to do it, and he will gather us. Let's do it together this morning. Lift up your voice and begin to talk to God that when revival comes, I see myself as the first person on line of action that God will do it. Let's do it together. Let's pray. Father, this morning, O God, I come before you, O God, in every form, in every revival state, O God, that we are just calling up before you, O God. Revival begins, O God, it begins on me. And it begins on me, my God, and it transforms me and brings me up, my God. I really thank you that, Father, your word had already saturated and brought me up, O God, into every space, O God, that I might just be, O God. I always call, O God, a revival over my larger family as a whole, O God. Father, just a transition, this portion, oh God. Let it be an infectious something as the people came in and they made that vow that they will go between their families and between their kings, oh God, and make it known unto that there is a call for a return. Father, I pray not only for my children, not only for my nephews, but for the infection of the whole family as a whole. Father, that we are just believing that this family is going to be enlightened by your revival, oh God. I am believing and trusting the Lord God. You are going to make us, O God, to be revived. I come before your presence, O God, believing and trusting the Lord Jesus Christ, O God, because you are being the very one, O God, that you work your purpose and you do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, O God, in every way. Lord Jesus Christ, pull us through, pull us through, pull us through, pull us through, Lord Jesus Christ. I am believing and trusting you, Lord, my God, that you will continue to shine, O Lord. I am believing in every way, Lord God, that in every aspect of it, oh God, that you will continue to be. I am praying for our churches, oh God. I am praying for the churches, oh God, that they might be mindful of it, oh God. God, that it will be, oh God. I am believing and trusting the Lord Jesus Christ. My whole target is the church, my God, that we might come into that resolution and come into this kind of form, believing and trusting the Lord God. It's only you who would do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, oh God. I am believing and knowing exactly what you say that you would do it. May your name alone, my God, be captured and be revealed, oh God. I thank you in every way. I thank you for the mercy and for the joy that you're just doing, oh God, in Mori, and Messiah, Ragalori, Bakai the Miri, Baranda Shaya, the Bikaya, the Kuri, and Messiah, Makuri, and Messiah. I am believing and trusting, oh Lord, my God. Lord, my God, in Mori, and Balata Mosiah. I am praying in every way, Lord God. Help us, oh God, to be revived. Help us, oh God, to be revived. Help us, oh God, to revive. Lord God, in every way, Lord Jesus Christ, oh God, it from one man, it will infect everyone, my God. It began with Ezra. It extended unto the whole family, oh God. Father, I am praying, Lord Jesus Christ, that I might hold myself accountable unto this revival, oh God. I am believing that, Lord Jesus Christ, there's going to be a revival, oh God. There's going to be a revival. We believe in the Lord Jesus Christ that is coming up, oh God. It is within the confinement, oh God. Father, we needed you, oh Lord. Father, we need you, oh God. We are believing, oh Lord, my God. Lord, oh God, we believe, oh God, you will stretch forth and bring us, oh God, into every being, oh God, that will continue to shine, will continue to grow, will continue to live in every aspect of our life, my God, that we'll be living, oh God. We thank you, Lord, my God, in every way. Father, move us into every way. We thank you and we bless you. We honor you, oh God. Thank you, Lord, oh God, you are our Sakadori and Messiah. Lord, our God, you are such an amazing God. You will never leave us alone, my God. You will never leave us without a switch, oh God. Help us, oh God. Help us, oh God. My God, we need it. We're calling for revival, oh God. Father, build on us, oh God. Lord, my God, Father, I'm believing, oh Lord, my God. Lord, the Makaida Miri, Barano Sikaturi, Makaida Miri, and Messiah, Rakalu, Makai. Father, we need an action, oh God. We need an action base, oh God. We need an action, oh God, that our whole being, my God, will be, that we will never leave, my God, and we'll never leave things unattended, oh God. May your name, oh God, be lifted and be glorified. We thank you and we bless you that, Lord Jesus Christ, you will do whatever is necessary, that your name will be glorified both now and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Beloved, our next line of action is that we're going to pray for families. You know, families that are going through, like Tuesdays, we always devote for families. You pray for any family. Some families are doing very well. You want God to continue with them. Some families, they are having troubles about marital problems. Some families have a diverse of issues that you come across them. And this morning, I want you to scan through the families that you know and begin to pray for them, because some will not even tell you, but your eye, God gave you eye and discerning heart to know exactly what's going on. And then I want you to just lift them all up before the Lord. Remember to pray also for our Mama Comfort. Pray for her wherever that is she is, you know. Pray for families, and then pray for this morning. I moved to pray also for the Whitley family. That is Mama Whitley's family. Children that are scattered around and needed that kind of cohesion and the love that will just blend within. You have so many things going on in this family, and I want us to use the Whitley's family as a point of contact to enter into every family that you know. So if you have no any other family even praying for, pray for the Whitley's. That's Mama Rita's family. I want you to just put them before the scope and see what the Lord will do. They are the point of contact for this morning. And so let us enter into every home and this morning and greet everyone and lift up every family before the presence of God. And I want you also to remember to pray for Auntie Agi, who is in Ghana now. lost the brother, and they are finding a way of bringing the funeral up, and it's a whole lot of issues going on in this family also. I want you to also remember them and pray that there will be peace and tranquility that will be even in this kind of funeral stage and all kind of thing. As they come together, God will just do them a miracle. You know families that you can also lift them all up together. And for the next 3 minutes, that's what we are going to travel on. Lift them all up before the Lord and let's do it together. Let's do it together because God will hear the prayer of the saints. Lift up every family before God. Let's do it. Father, this morning, oh God, we pray, oh God, and lift up, oh God, the Whitley family, my God, before you in every way, in every escort, oh God, that you will do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, oh God. Father, this has been a family, now God, when you hear the cases, oh God, that is going in here and there, sickness here and there, and trouble here and there, and not all kind of issues that is resolving. It takes only the hand of God, my God. Remember them. Remember the Whitley family, oh God. Father, remember them, oh Lord Jesus Christ. Lift them all up, oh God. I am also praying the Lord Jesus Christ, and I am praying as a point of contact to God that within the children and within the grandchildren, within every person, oh God, that is so new, my God. Therefore, Lord God, do them a favor, oh God. I am praying also, my God, the Lord Jesus Christ, lifting up before you, oh God, and lifting up before you, Auntie Aggie and their family, my God, you begin to do them a favor and you work your purpose out, oh Lord Jesus Christ. You will do whatever, Lord, that it takes, oh God. This morning, I lift it up before you, Lord. My God, in every way, in every aspect of it, oh God. Father, let it be according to your God. Let it be, Lord Jesus Christ, that we will be here in every way, my God. Father, I pray for Dr. Juice's sister, my God, who is going through this very kind of issue, my God, where, Lord God, that they are finding themselves in this trouble, oh God. Father, just crown them up and give them successful, oh God. I am praying also, Lord, God, that this family, oh God, that Lord Jesus Christ, that you would do them a favor, oh God, Lord, not only them, oh God. I pray for the Ezurike family, Lord Jesus Christ, lift them all up, oh God. I pray for Okoli's family, my God, I'm believing in Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for Basel's family, my God, and I pray for Christopher family, Lord Jesus Christ. They are the people, oh God, that you have surrounded me with all success, oh God. Father, that this year and this very time, oh God, we will see the fullness of your glory in every way. Father, we will see the fullness of your glory. Because, oh God, there is nothing that you cannot do. I pray. I pray also for Pastor Samuel's family. I pray to the Lord Jesus Christ, oh God. Father, leaving the family behind, you will do it, oh God. I pray for other family members. I pray for Brother Dufu's family. I pray also, Lord, for all my friends. I pray for the families, oh God. Father, I lift them all up before you. God, coach them and work your purpose, oh God. I pray for Dufu's family, oh God. Father, the daughter, Dorcas, my God, having that degree and have no job, my God. I am praying to the Lord Jesus Christ this morning, oh God. Turn unto them and work your purpose, oh God, and you do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, oh God. I am praying for Mama Comfort and Lord God, just to comfort them, oh Lord Jesus Christ. It takes only you, my God, to do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, oh God. I am believing and trusting the Lord God. It is within the confinement, the Lord Jesus Christ, you will do. I am praying by this method and by all you, my Lord. This is the day that, Lord God, that you will just thank you, Lord, my God. Ragalori bakandaya shikeri bakai de buri. Ragalori bahana masakunde maram. Mataya de bukuri ada basandaya de bikoya. Father, I am believing and trusting, O Lord Jesus Christ. We are believing, O Lord, my God, you will work your purpose and you will do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, O God. Help us, O God, and help our family, O God. Father, help our family, oh God. Lord Jesus Christ, we have oh God, this girl, oh God, that will one day, God, bring us into every kind of problem. I'm praying to the Lord Jesus Christ, let them be calmness and joy, oh God, and we'll be satisfied and we'll see that nothing will hinder us, but we'll go on and on, oh God. And remarkably, my God, we will do it, oh God, and see the fullness of your glory, oh God. I really thank you and bless you, and I believe in and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, oh God, for all the mercy and the joy that you are establishing us, O God. May you alone, my God, be lifted and be glorified. Both now, Lord God, we thank you and we bless you, even in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 This morning, is there anyone that you want us to stand with you in prayer? Tell us exactly what you wanted us to pray about for you this morning. Is there anyone? Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Mm. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we will pray with you. And I was going to ask you exactly, that was my first question that I was going to do, because I know today is the 7th, and the 7th comes with all kind of thing. It's a time I never forget. I will never forget 7th January, February, 14th February. It's a remarkable time. So when anything falls on that, I know that the victory had already been won. And so we will be praying and standing in with, for the judge even to turn around and say that I have not done this. I will hear the case. I will hear it this time. It's not going to come by the victory of the judge, the lawyers, or whoever is going to come by, but it's going to be a hard way, but a slip margin, that this issue will just go just like that. It's going to come by a slip margin, and then it will be not a big win, but just a slight margin. That's what we call the window of opportunity. That's called the grace. That's this little grace will just enter there. And prayer is one of the area that it opens. When there is darkness, it opens the avenue for it. We will stand with you in prayer. Is there anyone again? Mm-hmm. So you're thanking the Lord, right? Yeah. Yeah. Thank God. Have you started that job? Oh, that's Jessica. Oh, okay. I thought it's my sister Ngozi. Yeah. All right. We will pray and thank God on your behalf. Is there anyone again? Amen. You can just imagine that the next slip would have been a fatal. And we have already declared that we will never die prematurely. Any premature things will never stand our way. It will only come. We will only see it with our eyes and see the reward of the wicked, because we are not going to be part of that deal. We are minus us. If it flows and rolls out of the cliff, it will come and land straight, and there will be nothing, no scratch, no hitch, nothing will just be. Thank God for His grace and for the joy. When it comes like this, you will see your heartbeat rises up. Your temperature will be like almost, the only thing that is said, wow, that is the neck of a wood. God did a miracle. Amen. We will stand with you and thank God. Is there anyone again? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, so you can see that this is a joy. Mm-hmm. Go ahead. Mm-hmm. 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 Okay. We will do that. Is there anyone again? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Amen. We will be praying for you. Is there anyone again? Wonderful. So we have that this morning we need the hand of God to break through the prison doors, prison gates, dark clouds, and any kind of tunnel that doesn't belong to this sister. What's the name of your sister again? Oh, Sylvia. Uh-huh. We'll pray for Sylvia, and then we also have Thanksgiving that we wanted to say that help me to thank God. And we're just going to be in any Thanksgiving, we will just lift it up before the Lord. And the Thanksgiving again goes to how God delivered out from something that would have been a fatal also, and then transitioning, that we requested this thing for a long time. It took a while, but final thing has just been made, and also about a job interview that is coming up, and then also a direction into ministry as the Lord reveals them and broadens them. That God will give you the direction as to how to do it. I want us to go before the Lord in this 3 minutes to lift it up before the Lord, and then you bring your request at the end of the 3 minutes, and then you pray that the Lord will lead you and direct you throughout this day. Let's all do it together this morning. Let's do it together. Father, this morning we lift it up before you, O God. Sylvia, my God, in every aspect of it, oh God, we believe that, oh God, when you set up a very dynamic way, oh God, you will bring all things under control, oh God. We are believing and trusting you, Lord Jesus Christ. You do whatever, oh God, that it takes, oh God, in every aspect of it, oh God, that you do whatever, oh God. I am believing and trusting the Lord God, how the prison doors were closed, oh God. Father, this is a judge that is going to sit before you, my God, knows exactly one thing, the Lord Jesus Christ, you are going to do, oh Lord, my God. I am praying in every way, Lord Jesus Christ. Father, help Sylvia out. Help her out, oh God, that the judges, oh God, will just come into her aid, oh God. I am praying, oh Lord Jesus Christ, without you, my God, this day, oh Lord, we are trusting and believing, oh God, for the release, oh God, that my relief will surely appear, my Lord Jesus Christ. We are trusting, oh Lord God, in every will, oh God, Doria Tashika Pokaya, Matayana Bukuru Wakande Muria Basakateri Bakaya Biria, Alamakunda Masaya Tabiria. I am praying, oh Lord God, Bekabuka Tabiri, Barada Basakateri, Adamasakataya, Metaya Tabiki Terabatu, Hindamasaka Tukuri, Adamasandaya Tekiburia, Ragalai Tabiria, Adamasaya Tabikaya Tabiria. Father, we are praying in the Lord Jesus Christ. Come down and work your purpose, oh God. We wanted to just stand up and, oh God, bring up a praise unto you. I pray for Jessica. I pray for Jessica, Lord Jesus Christ. I lift her up, my God, as she is thanking you with the family, my God, knowing exactly what goes on within, oh God. Except, oh God, that you build Jessica's life, my God. She will never know exactly what how to thank you for, my God. I am believing and trusting the Lord Jesus Christ you will do, oh God. I am thanking you for Mama Rita, my God, for whatever, Lord God, that will deal with just the enemy, my God, that you could have, my God, just falling out from a cliff, oh God. Oh, my God, that is not going to be, my Lord Jesus Christ, that you would do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, oh God, in every aspect of it, oh God, that you do it, oh God. I am praying and thanking you, oh God, for the transitioning that has come, oh God. I am believing and trusting you, Lord Jesus Christ. What do you continue to do? What do you continue to shine? God, you continue to grow. I'm praying in every way, Lord Jesus Christ. You will give us every direction, oh God, that you will do whatever, Lord God, that it takes, oh God. May your name alone, your God, be seasoned and be glorified, oh God. We thank you that, Lord Jesus Christ, there is nothing, the Lord God, that you cannot do, oh God. This morning, our heart, oh God, to yearn within and believing and trusting the Lord Jesus Christ. You will bring all these sin into you. That's where the Boriana Kalaburi, Masakati, Bakaya Biri, Arabashandaya, Lord our God, let it be a God me, Anna Saikati Kiria, Ragaluri, Bakaya Miri, Arabasakaturi, Bakana Miri, Barana Masakaturi, Bakaya Miri, Barana Makara, Bimanakalai the Buri, Barana Masakati, Bakaya, Lord our God in Buri, Barana Masam, Imuri Arabasakati, Ragaluri, Bakaya Biri, Barana Masakaturi, Bakana Miri, and Masaya. Eri ada bakai dan buri ada bakai. Lima nak kalah buri bakai dan buri bakai. Lima nak canda masai katuri bakai dan buri ada. Lima nak kalah ide biri. Barada masuria ragaluri bakai dan muta ada biri. Barada masai katuri. Lord Jesus Christ, you are affected to God. May the mood man the muka jemuri. Barada masai katuri bakai dan mene kan buri. Lima nak kalah ide buri ada bakai ada bakai. Ragaluri bakai dan buri. Barada masai dan buri. Ragaluri hana kan dan buri. Lima nak kalah ide buri. Rebasaya, Ragaluri Bahana Saikaturi Bakaina Miri, Baranama Saikaturi Bakaya Buria, Limarakalai de Biri, Baranama Saikaturi Bakaya. Lord our God, do whatever, Lord God, that it always take, O God. The impossible will always be. We thank you that you will always do, O God. Rotaya de Buri Rebasaikatia. We thank you, O Lord, my God, that your name will be lifted and be glorified. We give you all the praise and we give you all the glory. Even in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. 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 I don't know who is called Faustina. Who is called Faustina? Is anyone? Good. When we get off the line, I wanted to talk to you, right? Okay. She could get it was Sunday at the beginning and I can do a video on the shaky and I can let a motive on the socket. Okay. Wonderful. Good. Minister Necker. Wonderful. Tonight, before you come, you've studied the chapter 7 of Leviticus. You've studied the book of Leviticus chapter 7. We're just going through. It's an Old Testament, but we're finding exactly who Christ is and what it means, because you have to know the personality and know his work. Separate them and know exactly who Christ is. And Leviticus is a book that reveals Jesus Christ more. And thank God that today we have also gone out of Book of Ezra. And this next 2 days, Pastor Samuel will be taking us through some time with us. And so, God willing, tomorrow you will hear a voice. Pastor Samuel will just minister to us and minister on the next day too. So before we transition and come to the second Corinthians, and then we move back also to Nehemiah, and we will also move to Daniel, because they go together, Ezra, Nehemiah, and Daniel, they go together. So I wanted to do these three books, the next two books after 2 Corinthians, so we can just jog in between and get ourselves really refreshed. And I know we are going very, very far, and we're learning every day new thing in the scriptures. So this morning, for the authority vested in me, I wanted to make some proclamation and make some declaration. And when issues are really, you know, round about and you cannot even figure out what to do, we only have a God that says that, pray with me that these things will not be an issue any longer, that God will throw out everything from the court system, and then God will always champion his cause and give us the victory that we needed. So some people are sneaking and snatching, coming out to sue people and put them into some kind of, you can't just believe how people are doing in many other ways. But whatever be the case, whatever case is going before judge, or judge is going to make a decision over your issue, I'm also going to stand with you. But using Sylvia as a point of contact for all cases that will appear before the judge, by which you see that if they call out without the Lord, I tell you, you will lose the battle. But God will use this as a shining example to bring up a deliverance, and I pray over the issues. Let's pray. Our God and Heavenly Father, by the authority vested in me, your word says that I should make up a decree, and it will be honored. And therefore, Lord, I stand in this threshold, believing and trusting that there's one thing that separates and separates forever, and it is now all eternity. And therefore, Father, when some people go through some other kind of scuffles and then some darkness and some other troubles, Father, they have no other one to come in their aid except that. Therefore, I stand in this great office, and I proclaim that, Lord Jesus Christ, that which has not been done before, that which have never, my God, come into light. We've seen people whose cases, my God, went and it was almost like even a drug something. And then the people were in prison for how many years, we don't know. By the prayer on the same line, my God, you deliver the person and then you set the person free. Today the person is walking out free. And yet we see the hand of God that is able to do. I stand in the same great authority, O God, that because you have done it before, this time is going to be the one that will blow the mind of us and then go into another section. I am praying and declaring that, Lord Jesus Christ, let it be the simplicity and use the technicalities and everything, O God, to hit the whole thing. Father, there have been an omission, O God, and this omission will not be the inheritance, O God, and because something was omitted, O God, and therefore, Lord God, this time is going to come to the glaring. I lift it up before you, my God. That section that, O God, that was omitted, that could have acquitted there, my Lord, I bring it before before you. And I pray that, Lord Jesus Christ, this is an injustice, oh God. I can see, my God, a foul that should have been, and a kind of thing that could have been a world of defending, my God. That is why we are not resting until you see a victory, oh God. I am praying, oh God, as a way of victory for Sylvia. It is going to infect the line with anybody, my God, having any case before the judge, before any kind of court. It doesn't matter whether a small court, a big court, or even to the Supreme Court. I prayed and I plead, oh God, we're calling out for this file, and I pray that God uplift this thing, this omission. It's a big omission, oh God. Therefore, oh God, that it will just come, and then we will stand up on that threshold. We will not be angry with those who persecute us, but because we know that it was for a reason and for a season. The season is over. The 70 years is over, and therefore the release has come, and therefore I sound that victory, oh God. Therefore, let it be as a threshold and bring it out, and therefore we will just stand in it. My God, the next victory is that we're going to hear, oh, the release of Sylvia. And Sylvia will shout and just pray and glorify you, because once the prayer has just been lifted, oh God, it will not just come before you. Father, I stand in this great office and I make a proclamation, oh God, this is not going to, you are not going to rest until you see your children through. And we pray that, God, may this thing never, oh God, come into a nagging area, my God, but it will just come under a threshold by which only you have picked and you have chosen, oh God, that it will be. Because this is a vessel that you are going to use for so many things, my God, that will break forth and do exploit unto you. For only you, God, knows exactly how to tame man, and you only, God, knows how to use another person, oh God, to bring up a deliverance and bring up a whole thing, oh God. I stand in this great treasure, oh God. I proclaim that, my God, this woman, Sylvia, will come and begin to serve you as never, my God. I declare that, Father, she is not going to be the kind of person that she used to be, my God. She will stand out, oh God, among the crowd, oh God, and she will be the defender, oh God, and do exactly what it is, my God. Oh, Lord God, could it be that, oh God, I prophesy that, oh God, from this point, oh God, she will even take up another kind of education. She is going to study law, and from that point, she will know exactly to become a lawyer. Father, I am praying and declaring that, Father, how can it be from prison to become a lawyer? It doesn't work that way, but this is going to happen, my God. I stand in this great office, whether it is many, oh God, it has already been sanctioned, and therefore, God, for the people to know that really you are a God. Just do exactly what you have just done, because we trust you, and that's why we bring every contract unto you. I pray for every, the slightest ones, the small ones that are individuals, some suing, some other people are just ridiculing and putting people in that kind of embarrassing situation. Today they push them into this court, the next day they change the court, and all the systems of court that do God. Some people know the system, that they can destroy system of God. I pray that, God, all these cessations must cease. And let it be that your people will have the pass through, and therefore there will not be anything. Father, if there is anything, we have to get a sound mind. It doesn't matter whether it's an immigration judge. It doesn't matter whether it's a kind of court issue, my God. Bring deliverance and bring healing and bring joy unto your people once again. We wanted to knock on this line and just say that God has been so good to us. We pray for those that, Lord God, and I thanking you and blessing you for all what you just done and what you continue to do. So I'm saying that, Lord, I am thanking you because of my family and just help us starting the farm of Jessica. God, just bless the family as the Thanksgiving lifted up before you. Pray for Thanksgiving for Mama Rita, my God, that could have folded in something very terrible, my God, but you stood in, and then she's bringing you a Thanksgiving, and we say, may your name be glorified. I pray for the transition, my God. Oh, I don't know how many years that, God, this prayer has gone, and how many delays that have gone. Now, finally, the man has already gotten what he wanted of God, and I'm believing and trusting the Lord Jesus Christ. This is now the good time for us to see the hand of God, and I'm praying for that the Son of God that will also go for an interview, that Lord Jesus Christ, it will just be a one touch, and then the desire of their heart will be made. I pray finally for the direction of whatever, Lord God, that you are just transitioning and bringing your daughter into, my God. She said that she has identified the location. She said, therefore, Lord God, it becomes easily, my God, to be absorbed. And I pray that God, by that direction, as to when and how and what to do, Lord God, lies within your strength. She doesn't want to mess up and do anything by her own instinct. She wants to do according to your push. So, Lord, push her, and she is ready to do exploit unto you. Now, finally, I pray for every issue that, God, that we could not even number it on this line. And as we are not leaving your presence. Your presence will go with us and will open up every door that has already been opened, my God, by you alone, and close anything that, God, that will just put us off and make us not to become shining examples unto you, the living God. We are ambassadors of Christ, and we live and die for you, Jesus Christ, and therefore let it be that, God, it will be a record that there are many things that are falling apart. This time around, everything will rise in Jesus' name. I am praying that, God, we will never fall short, we will never lack, and the strength of you, O Lord, will only project. What is it that you cannot do? Is it too hard for you? Nothing, absolutely. Absolutely nothing is impossible. When the name of Jesus Christ is mentioned, every knee will bow, every tongue will confess, and even judges and every person that God that lifts itself against even the knowledge of God will still bow, because Jesus stands and everyone bows. We thank you for what you are going to do today. We will just have another way of breaking forth our singing and our rejoicing and our honor. I pray to the Lord, it will just come that your people will once again see the victory of you, the living God. I thank you and I bless you, even in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 Yes. Yes. Whose birthday? Sister Gloria. Yes, I think she's traveled, but it's still, she's part of us. So wherever she is, I don't know whether she has returned. Yes, Sister Gloria. Is she the one having her birthday? All right. So, beloved, as birthday goes, so goes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Gloria, happy birthday to you, and may God bless you now, may God bless you now, may God bless you, Gloria, may God bless you now. Father, we just wanted to celebrate this birthday with our sister Gloria, believing and trusting that wherever that she is still not forgotten, oh God. I plead the mercy and the grace of God, oh God, that will be upon her life. If there is anything that is becoming a stumbling block, whatever, Lord God, that is not iron to be straight, my God, put every crooked way straight, oh God, and work for her good. Let us see that the years ahead of her is nothing that she had ever seen, my God, and make a bold transition in her life, that she will always have a praise report to glorify and to honor you. There is nothing impossible that you cannot do. Thank you for adding 1 year. This is another milestone, and we all celebrate with her, and we believe that, God, this is a remarkable event. May your name be glorified and be lifted both now and forevermore, even in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 I want you to place your right hand over your chest, and I'm just going to pronounce a blessing upon you as you leave this line. Now, dear Father, our God, the Father of all creation, the Lord that treasures us so much that you came in and you died in our place. May you be lifted up in every issue that God, that is being dimming our hopes. May our hopes never be interrupted just because you have placed us on a position that is always a fixed one. I know that when the conditions are not even meeting, my God, you have a way of turning it around and then interrupting even the condition. And therefore the condition, oh my God, the condition will never be the same because you will have a touch over it. And when you turn the condition around, it will be a blessing unto your people. God, the position is fixed, and then only the condition will be tempered on. And I'm believing and I trust that we are going out with a full heart and a chest full of joy, believing and trusting that that which has been impossible for many days, because today we have touched our chest to God, believing that everything is possible through the one alone who defends us and who brings us forth. May his name be glorified. Now, unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the throne of grace with exceedingly joy, to the only wise God, to him be glory, majesty, power, both now and forevermore. The Lord God will bless you and he will keep you. The Lord God will make his face shine upon you and he will be gracious towards you. The countenance of Jehovah God will never bring into your life any frustration. For frustration, it will cease. And all issues will cease. The hand of God will lead you through and you are a victor. Go and proclaim liberty, because wherever that you will stand, you have already won before it's being declared. May your name, Jesus, be glorified both now and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. When there is a steady, there will be a revival. When there is a revival, there will be confession. When there is confession, there will be what? When there is confession, there will be what? Repentance. And when there is repentance, there will be action. Go in this vein and proclaim liberty wherever you are. God has blessed you forever. Be blessed. Shalom, shalom, shalom.
Shalom. Yes.
Yes. Yes, yes, stay on.
Wonderful. My dear, yes. Dr. Uju? Uh-huh. Wonderful. The first thing is that let me take this opportunity just to apologize for last Sunday, what happened about Minister Neke's birthday. They call us that they were going to have a birthday at 12 o'clock at the dinner place. So after church, then my wife had then not slept. So I said, okay, let's go there and then we will just have something to, because I made it, we came home, she changed and then she went out to the place. We went to the place, not knowing they have changed the time to 3 o'clock. And so we were just there waiting that this is becoming something. So I went in and I asked the restaurant people that, where is it, not the same place that they're going to have the lunch? He said, oh yeah, looked at the name, he said, oh, they have changed it to 3 o'clock. Oh, and nobody informed us. So then I told my wife that, okay, let's go down, and then, because it's my fault, because I should have even called them first to know whether they are leaving home before. Once they told me, and they, even Adana said that we should sit by 12, we have to be seated. So I know that Bahamas, they will let me go and pray. I would have, you know, taken my time, because me, restaurant food is not my choice. So I would have taken my time to even go there, but once it's a birthday and they said come at that point, I knew that they wanted me to pray and have whatever that they have. And that's why we stood, and later we found that they were not coming. And then I called Adana, I called them, their phone was also, nobody was picking it up. And then Adana too, because I don't want to call the mother, maybe it's a secret that they are doing for her. Right, so I didn't want to call her. And then not knowing, when they told her, she had already made up an appointment with somebody at 12:30 to meet the person, and so they changed the time when they should have really informed me. They never informed me. And so when we came, it was almost like 1:15. And my wife said, oh, no, I can't go again, because the whole night I didn't sleep. I said, oh yeah, now just sleep. So I even thought of not going. Then Adana called me and asked, no, Pastor, we are sorry. We changed the thing. I said, I've been there. Nobody said anything anyway. So after 3 o'clock, then I said, oh, that was the time that we should have left here to your place. Yeah, because at that time, I know even if you went to church, you have come home and everything, and there we spent all this time not sleeping. My wife was not sleeping. I said, okay, she should sleep. And then I told her that she should send a text message and just tell that I am sleeping, and therefore Dr. Uju will be the one who will just know and understand that when you finish your night, you don't play with it. Yeah. Yeah, what is going on is that the moment I was praying, what I heard was that relationship. And it's almost like the one who was saying it was shaking the head. You know, shaking the head as no. So I wanted to find out if a person's a sister or a friend or whatever acquaintance that has the name, I will only ask about the relationship. How do you see it? As on your own perspective, and lo and behold, you said that your husband's sister is called that name. And so, what's your relationship with her? Oh, you don't have any problem with whatsoever? Okay. Praise God. What I was just saying, you know, that I'm just only going to pray that that as you have just seen as something that without any kind of thing which is not your knowledge, God will still guide this relationship and, you know, move it into the level that you always because we carry our trouble. We don't want anybody to come and add anything to us. That's what I always pray for people, that look, me, what I'm carrying is too big for you to come and add another one to me. And so, yeah, so it is. And I will pray. And also today, you were just on my mind. I was going to call you and then have it in that aspect that, you know, we will be able to see your sister's case, how it is. So the lawyers, how did it go? Oh, so they finally got through, but we don't do things like that. Okay, so we are trusting that there will be a good results that will just come out as it is. And so, yeah, so apart from that, the home, everything is going on well at home, right? Okay, let me pray. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for Faustina. And thank you for what was just as it came in with what kind of relationship, we don't know. Father, you know the heart of man and you know exactly what goes on in every intent. Sometimes we can smile, but in between, in us, deep in us, there will be something that we cannot even know it. But I pray that with this cordiality that has always been the progressing report, that there will be cordialness that will just put them into that right mind where they will just say that this is the dealing of the Lord. Whatever that the enemy will also use in the future against this relationship is what we stand up against it, and we trash it and we curse it and we say let it never even rise. We also thanking you for the final thing which the lawyers now did what is good, that after all, they are not going to be the one who is going to bring the deliverance. It's the Lord. Why do they have to go ahead and threaten and thinking that they have the hand of God, they have the hand to turn things around? God can change it by his own stroke of his pen. Father, now is the hour. I am only standing in with this, my sister, believing that that which we have all trusted and believed will also come as our relief. We have a brighter time, almost like 5.5 hours from now, the court issue will proceed. And we will see the hand of you, the living God, doing the impossible. And believing that whatever that has already come in, all children will find their mother and husband will see the wife. And and the wife will know the husband and there will be joy that will return, my God. I pray to the Lord Jesus Christ, you are the one and only that can lift this case up. And thank God that for this submission that has been found, and this submission can just bring up her acquittal for life. And it will just be that she will just be there. We are not asking for even paying us back, but the joy of her walking out and bringing something good, it is, because this was injustice, but yet, God, you've only followed through the trail and you've won decades. We give praise and glory, and we honor you that we are going to witness in the next 5 hours and beyond, that it will be something spectacular and it will blow our mind. We give you all the praise and glory. We want all these things to cease, any kind of eddies that would just be an attraction that has nothing to do with your glory. God, let them cease. All money throwing out into the drain must cease. And therefore, there will be joy that will be established with them forever. We thank you that you will do this, because you have pleaded in one name. It's the matchless name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Amen. So, my dear, keep me posted and let me know exactly what is going on, right? Good. Call me. Yes. Today you are still off or you are starting again? Oh, today? Okay. Wow. And you'll be leaving today, right? Forty minutes, yeah, okay. Okay. Ah, okay. 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 You let it go. okay, yeah, since you are helping, it's not anything that you have to. All right, so keep me posted. I've been keeping vigil the whole night. I've not slept, so I'm believing something good will come. Oh, good. So let it be that way, right? God bless you. Mm-hmm. We'll hear from you very soon. Mm-hmm. All right. All right. Shalom. Mm-hmm.